First of all, tell you there's nothing more in PDF file except this. Okay, the Lyman series of hydrogen correspond to an electron transition from a higher level to N1. What is the longest wavelength in that series? Longest wavelength correspond to the smallest energy. The smallest energy is for the smallest transition. So you have, let's say, some positive core, and you have N1, N2, N3, N4. This is N equal 1, this is N equal 2, this is N equal 3, this is N equal 4. So energy of the photon will be equal to that difference in energies of electron level. So if that electron transit from here to here, you can see that this gap is fairly large. So energy, bond energy at this point here is much larger than this one here, so the energy of that photon will be larger than the energy of this photon and the energy of this photon. So smallest possible energy for the photon is transition from here to here. Smallest possible energy corresponds to the largest possible wavelength or longest wavelength. So transition from n is equal 2 to n is equal 1 correspond to the lowest energy or to the highest frequency and at the same time to the lowest wavelength. Equations for that you don't need, but energy is equal h time need. This is the Planck constant, this is the frequency. Sometimes it's written as h time f, which is the same thing, because that is the light. C is equal frequency times wavelength. From this equation, frequency is equal C divided by wavelength. So this equation becomes H times C divided by lambda. So H and C are constant in this case. So, and these are constant, and this is the wavelength, this is the energy. And you can see that the smallest the wavelength, the largest the energy, and the largest the wavelength, the smallest the energy. So for the smallest energy, the wavelength will be the largest. Okay, and this is the equation, how do you calculate energy from transition from here to here. We are using Rydberg constant. Luckily there is a Rydberg constant. So 1 divided by lambda is equal to Rydberg constant times 1. This is n squared minus 1 divided by this n squared. This is 1 and this is 2. So lambda from here is, when you flip this over, that is lambda divided by 1, that is lambda, and 1 divided by all of this. Or you could say these two things can switch places and nothing will happen. The equation will still stand. So lambda is equal to this, that is a 3/3, you're just placing the numbers and that's all there is to it. So from here to here, meter to minus 1, when it climbs up it will be meter to 1, that is just meter. 10 to the 7, when it climbs up, let's say, it will change its sign, so it will be 10 to the minus 7. And from here to here, if you multiply this by 100, you have to divide this by 100. So we have here, when you divide this by 100, you're effectively dividing this with a 10 to the second, and then you get 10 to the minus 9. 10 to the minus 9 is actually nanometers. 10 to the minus 9 meters is actually nanometer, or 10 to the minus 9 is actually nano. So that wavelength is 121 nanometers. When it passes from here to here. Now, you could calculate what would wavelength be if it passes from here to here. He would be number 3, and he would be number 1. And then you could see that that wavelength will be smaller than this. And this wavelength will be smaller from that, and so on and so on. You could test that. Test this. So, if you want to donate, you could do that by downloading complete written answer, which link is in the description. If you want more of this, please subscribe and tell your friends. Thank you. Bye.